morning in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Amen.
Our help is in the name of the Lord. If you, O Lord, kept a record of sins, O Lord, who could stand?
Though of you there is forgiveness, therefore you are here.
Since we are gathered to hear God's word, to call upon him in prayer and praise, and receive the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ in the fellowship of this altar, let us first consider our own unworthiness and confess before God and one another that we have sinned in thought, word, and deed, that we cannot free ourselves from our sinful condition. Together as his people, let us take refuge in the infinite mercy of God. And sing together,
God, be merciful to me, a sinner.
Almighty God, have mercy upon us. Forgive us our sins and lead us to everlasting life. Almighty God, in his mercy, has given his Son to die for you, and for his sake forgives you all of your sins. As a called and ordained servant of Christ, and by his authority and in his stead, I therefore give you all of your sins in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Blessed are those whose strength is in you,
in whose heart thy wisdom is found.
How lovely is your dwelling place,
O Lord of hosts.
My soul longs, yes, faints for the courts of the Lord.
My heart and flesh sing for joy to the living God.
Even the sparrow finds a home, and in the shallow a nest for herself, where she may lay her young.
At your altars, O Lord of hosts, my King and my God.
Blessed are those who dwell in your house,
ever singing your praise.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son,
and to the Holy Spirit,
as it was in the beginning,
is now, and will be forever. Amen.
Blessed are those whose strength is in you,
in whose heart thy might is found.
Gracious to all who have gone astray from your ways, and bring them again with repentant hearts and steadfast faith to embrace and hold fast the unchangeable truth of your word. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
I'd ask the congregation to please be seated as we continue with our baptism. I'd ask Judy and Jane and Joyce. Begin in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Dearly beloved, Christ our Lord says in the last chapter of Matthew, all authority in heaven and on earth has been given to me. Therefore, go and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and the Holy Spirit. In the last chapter of Mark, our Lord promises, whoever believes and is baptized will be saved. The Apostle Peter has written, baptism now saves you. The Word of God also teaches that we are all conceived and born sinful and are under the power of the devil until Christ claims us as his own. We would be lost forever unless delivered from sin, death, and everlasting condemnation. But the Father of all mercy and grace has sent his Son, Jesus Christ, to atone for the sin of the whole world, that whoever believes in him should not perish, but have eternal life. How are you to be named?
Judy.
Judy. Receive the sign of the cross, both upon your forehead. Let's do this right. On your forehead. And also upon your heart. To mark you as a redeemed by Christ, the crucified. Let us pray. Almighty and eternal God, according to your strict judgment, you condemn the unbelieving world through the flood. Yet according to your great mercy, you perceive believing Noah and his family, 8 souls in all. You drown the hard-hearted Pharaoh and all his host in the Red Sea. Yet led your people, Israel, through the water on dry ground, foreshadowing the washing of holy baptism, through the baptism in the Jordan of your beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. You sanctified and instituted all waters to be a blessed flood and a lavishing washing away of sin. We pray that you would behold Judy according to your boundless mercy and bless her with true faith by the Holy Spirit, that through this saving flood all sin in her, which has been inherited from Adam and which she committed since, would be drowned and die. Grant that she be kept safe and secure in the holy ark of the Christian Church, being separated from the multitude of unbelievers and serving your name at all times with a fervent spirit and with joyful hope, so that with all believers in your promise, she would be declared worthy of eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
We pray together the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Lord, preserve your coming and the going out from this time and forevermore. Amen. Judy, do you renounce the devil?
Yes, I
do. Do you renounce all of his works?
Yes.
Do you renounce all his ways?
Yes.
Do you believe in God the Father, Almighty Maker of heaven and earth? Do you believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried? He descended into hell, and the third day he rose again from the dead, and ascended into heaven, and sits at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he will come to judge the living and the dead. Do you believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Christian Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting? Judy, do you desire to be baptized? Judy, I baptize you in the name of the Father and the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Almighty God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has given you the new birth of water and the Spirit, and has forgiven you all of your sins, strengthen you with his grace and life everlasting. Receive this burning light to show that you have received Christ, who is the light of the world. Live always in the light of Christ, and be ever watchful for his coming, that you may meet him with joy and enter with him into the marriage feast of the Lamb, whose kingdom will have no end. We welcome Judy into our family. member of his Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, and an heir with us of all the treasures of heaven in the one holy Christian and apostolic church. We receive you in Jesus' name as our sister in Christ, that together we might hear his word, receive his gifts, and proclaim the praises of him who called us out of darkness into his marvelous light. Amen. Welcome you in the name of the Lord. Let us pray. Almighty and most merciful God and Father, we thank you and praise you that you graciously preserve and enlarge your family and have granted Judy new birth and holy baptism and made her a member of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, and an heir of your heavenly kingdom. We humbly implore you that as she has now become your child, you would keep her in her baptismal grace, that according to your good pleasure, she may faithfully grow and lead a godly life to the praises and honor of your holy name, and finally, with all your saints, obtain the promised inheritance in heaven. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Heavenly Father, you sent your only Son into the world as the child of the Virgin Mary. We thank you for the life of Judy. We thank you for the life of Judy entrusted to our care. Help us remember we are all your children, and so love her and nurture her that she may attain to the full stature intended for her in your eternal kingdom. For the sake of Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. And finally, Almighty and everlasting God, since you govern and sanctify the whole Christian church by your Holy Spirit, hear our prayers for all her members, and mercifully grant that by your grace we may serve you in true faith through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Now may the peace of the Lord be with you. Amen. You may return.
Yeehaw!
Yeah, there you go. We continue with the reading of God's Word.
The Old Testament reading for today comes from Exodus chapter 17. All the congregation of the people of Israel moved on from the wilderness of Sin by stages, according to the commandments of the Lord, and camped at Rephidim, that there was no water for the people to drink. Therefore the people quarreled with Moses and said, "Give us water to drink." And Moses said to them, "Why do you quarrel with me? Why do you test the Lord?" But the people thirsted there for water, and the people grumbled against Moses and said, "Why did you bring us up out of Egypt to kill us and our children and our livestock with thirst?" So Moses cried to the Lord, "What shall I do with this people? They are almost ready to stone me." And the Lord said to Moses, "Pass on before the people, taking with you some of the elders of Israel, and take in your hand the staff with which you struck the Nile, and go. Behold, I will stand before you there on the rock of Horeb, and you shall strike the rock, and water shall come out of it, and the people will drink." And Moses did so in the sight of the elders of Israel, and he called the name of the place Massah and Meribah, because of the quarreling of the people of Israel, and because they tested the Lord by saying, "Is the Lord among us or not?" This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. And the epistle lesson today comes from Romans chapter 5. "Therefore, since we have been justified by faith, we have peace with God through our Lord Jesus Christ. Through him, we have also obtained access by faith into this grace in which we stand, and we rejoice in hope of the glory of God. More than that, we rejoice in our sufferings, knowing that suffering produces endurance, and endurance produces character, and character produces hope, and hope does not put us to shame, because God's love has been poured into our hearts through the Holy Spirit who has been given to us. For while we were still weak, at the right time, Christ died for the ungodly. For one will scarcely die for a righteous person, though perhaps for a good person, one would dare even to die. But God shows his love for us in that while we were still sinners, Christ died for us. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Please rise for the reading of the Holy Gospel.
The Holy Gospel according to St. John, the fourth chapter. Jesus came to a town of Samaria called Sychar, near the field that Jacob had given his son Joseph. Jacob's well was there, so Jesus, wearied as he was from his journey, sitting beside the well, was about the 16th hour. There came a woman of Samaria to draw water. Jesus said to her, "Give me a drink." For his disciples had gone away to the city to buy food. The Samaritan woman said to him, "How is it that you, a Jew, ask for a drink from me, a woman of Samaria? For Jews have no dealings with Samaritans." Jesus answered her, "If you knew the gift of God and who it is that is saying this to you, 'Give me a drink,' you would have asked him, and he would have given you living water." The woman said to him, "Sir, you have nothing to draw water with, and the well is deep. Where do you get that living water? Are you greater than our father Jacob? He gave us the well and drank from it himself, as did his sons and his livestock." Jesus answered her, "Everyone who drinks of this water will be thirsty again. But whoever drinks of the water that I will give him will never be thirsty forever. The water that I give him will become in him a spring of water welling up to eternal life." The woman said to him, "Sir, give me this water, so that I will not be thirsty or have to come here to draw water." Jesus said to her, "Go call your husband and come here." The woman answered him, "I have no husband." Jesus said to her, "You are right in saying that you have no husband, for you have had five husbands, and the one you now have is not your husband. What you have said is true." The woman said to him, "Sir, I perceive that you are a prophet. Our fathers worshipped on this mountain, but you say that in Jerusalem is the place where people ought to worship." Jesus said to her, "Woman, believe me, the hour is coming when neither on this mountain nor in Jerusalem will you worship the Father. You worship what you do not know. We worship what we know, for the salvation is from the Jews. But the hour is coming, the hour is now here, when the true worshipers will worship the Father in spirit and truth. For the Father is seeking such people to worship him. God is spirit, and those who worship him must worship him in spirit and truth." The woman said to him, "I know the Messiah is coming. He was called Christ. When he comes, he will tell us all things." Jesus said to her, "I who speak to you am he." This is the gospel of the Lord.
Praise you, O Christ.
You may be seated as we continue with the children's message. Come on up here, guys. Ooh, you guys got so much energy this morning. That's so great. Thank you for coming up. How are you? Good. Wow, so did you guys see what happened this morning? See this thing right here? Yeah, somebody got baptized. You know, we talked about those words. Baptism is really important. Is this a way that Jesus loves us and gives us forgiveness of sins? You know why we need forgiveness, right? You know why we need forgiveness? Are we always good? No. You know, I'm not always good either. And even I need forgiveness. But the really special thing about this is just the way that we use God's word and the elements of water. As he promises in his word, he says that if we're going to be baptized, that he'll forgive us. And you know what? He continues to forgive us even to this day. You know, because when we do bad things, you know, sometimes we just need to talk to God about it. You know, if I talk to God about things when I do bad things, you know what? It does a couple of things for me. It makes me feel better because I know that I'm still loved. Even sometimes when I don't even love myself because of the bad things I do. But Jesus promises he'll always love us and he will always forgive us. And that's what baptism reminds us, because you know what? Each one of you was baptized, at least the four of you, at this font too, right? So always remember, when you see water, like when you're fishing, you see all that water, think about when Jesus was baptized in the Jordan River, right? You know, sometimes when you wash your hands, you get all that dirt on there. Well, think about, you know, your baptism is it washes away your sins and makes you a new person. And we should always thank Jesus for giving us that cleansing and forgiveness, right? So let's pray to Jesus and thank you for that, Ken. Can you pray after me? Let's pray. Dear Jesus, thank you for forgiving me and cleansing me. I know you love me, and I love you too. All this we pray in Jesus. Amen. Because that's the pure truth, right? All right, thanks for coming up. You guys can go back to your seats. We continue with singing. Mercy and peace be to you from our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Amen. Let us pray. Spirit of God, we just ask that your Spirit would be amongst us this morning as we study your word, that you may convict us and show us the truth. All this we pray in Jesus' name. Amen. So the text for the message today comes from Exodus, the Old Testament lesson. And I want to focus on Exodus, but I'm also going to transition halfway through to 1 Corinthians 10, because Paul speaks to this message to the Corinthian church. So hang on to that thought for a minute. We're going to start with Exodus 17. And this is what Moses said. It was quite interesting, and this was kind of, this just captured me for some reason. It says, therefore the people quarreled with Moses and said, give us water to drink. Moses said to them, why do you quarrel with me? Why do you test the Lord, saying the Lord is not among us? So if you think about it in the contents of this scripture lesson, just think about the Exodus story in general. What's happened to the Israelite people up to this point? Well, there's a few things. I can think of a pillar or a fire, parting of the Red Sea. I can think of a snake on a pole. And today, we see water and a rock. So, kind of begs the question, what were the people so upset? Well, obviously, they had manna to eat. They had bread from heaven. Quail. The Lord just delivered them from where? From Egypt. He had been carrying them along for I don't know how many days, but he was with them. And they were quarreling with Moses to the point where Moses was afraid that, these guys are going to take me out in this desert and they're going to stone me. My life is in danger. And he comes back to the people and says, why are you doing this? Now hold that thought just for a minute. Think about the people. Why were they? Why were they doing this? Were they just in their action? Were they just in complaining? Were they just in quarreling? What about in our own lives? Do you feel sometimes God is just in your lives? You quarrel with God? Lord, why do you bring this on to me? Why do I have this sickness? Why is all this happening to me? When sometimes the answer to that question is standing right in front of me. But maybe we just don't even recognize it and see it. Do we get upset and test God? Maybe not trusting. Maybe thinking we have a better plan for success than he does. Is that really a lack of faith? What do you think? I test God. Yeah. In my sinful condition, sometimes even me, God, I appreciate this, but I think I'm going to go this route because I just have this notion that it's going to work out better for me. The interesting thing? Hindsight's 20/20, isn't it? Every one of those paths I took was nothing but a tragedy. It really, really was. So is it a sin to test God? What do you think? Yeah, it is. So in reality, the Israelites were sinning. You know why? Because they didn't fall back and trust that God was going to deliver them. He says, I'm going to take you to where? The promised land. We got to spend 40 years in the desert. Well, I guess if we would have been a little bit more trusting, it might have been only 25. But, it didn't happen that way, did it? And are humans hard-headed? I am. That's my why. We are by nature that way. We always gravitate to sin. That's just how buried and innate it is into our DNA. That's why this whole act of baptism this morning with Judy is so important. It just changes our lives and our hearts to where we can actually now accept the message of God and fully understand it and have that knowledge. So it's interesting. So what was God's response to the Israelites? What did he do? I'm surprised he just didn't like kick them out and say, go on. Okay, you're on your own, guys. No, he didn't do that, did he? He took care of them. He gave them water. Even though, you know, Moses was quarreling. I mean, Moses was whining. You know, they were quarreling and they were complaining. God still took care of his people. That's what God does. No matter what we've got going on in our situations and our lives and stuff, God will always be there to take care of us. You know why? Because we're his children. True fathers don't abandon their children, even when they're not, right? And that's what Jesus and God does for us today. So sometimes God provides for us and we don't even see it. If you think about it, what was he doing for the Israelites? We kind of talked about that, right? I mean, he was feeding them. I mean, in the middle of the desert, he provided them shade. He's giving them water now. He was still taking care of them. So through all this caring, this active caring for his Israelites, for the Israelite people, who was active in all this? So you could say God, but let's use the rock for an example. Who's active in all this? Well, if you look at Scripture, it's Jesus. I mean, already, even before Jesus came into this world, Jesus was already active, not only in creation, but also active in how things were going to come together with the Israelite people, all the way through the line of David, all the way up to Christ coming himself, which we study during this Lent season, right? If you read in 1 Corinthians 10, verse 4, this is what Paul talked about, the warnings from Israelites' history. So here's the lesson for us. Here's the lesson. This is what Paul teaches. For I don't want you to be ignorant to the fact, brothers and sisters, that our ancestors were all under the cloud, and that they all passed through the sea. They were all baptized into Moses in the cloud and in the sea. They all ate the same spiritual food, drank the same spiritual drink, for they drank from the spiritual rock that accompanied them. Can you imagine having a rock following these guys around? It's true. It's true. There was rocks all over the place, pouring out water for these guys. Spiritual food? Manna, right? That rock was Christ. So Christ has done some amazing things for his children. He's done it for me, and I'm sure he's done it for you too. You know? It's obvious how he cared for the Israelites, but he also cares for us today. He's always there and gives us care. Some examples. What are we getting ready to celebrate? People say, it's so sick you guys celebrated death. But it's such a glorious thing that happened through that death. We celebrate Christ's death, but his resurrection and the gifts that he gives to us through that as he carries our sins to the cross. Forgiveness, love, and the fellowship that we have together. We have a good time together, don't we? Boy, how do we do? Just stick around after church and see. Have some coffee. Wish I could stay. How about answered prayers? Ask my mom about answered prayers. She'll give you some advice on how to pray and answer prayers for somebody that can be a stinker. That's me. How about peace? The peace which surpasses all understanding. That peace of God that comes to us is so much more worth to me than all the money in the world. Because I need peace, lots of it. But also, Christ gives us purpose. And our purpose isn't in our job. It's not in our family. Our purpose is in Jesus and what he gives to us. And then he gives to us spiritual growth. As we continue to grow in our family together as his church, but individually with Jesus, we continue to grow, to be more like him, as he gives us the gifts that we need to survive in this tanked world with all its problems. So in closing, there will be times when we feel alone and abandoned by God. They just happen. That's just part of our sinfulness. But God will never abandon. God is with us when we struggle. That is why Jesus went to the cross, to carry all our sin, all our pain, and all our suffering with him to the cross. Jesus is still active today. He's active in each one of our lives, and he's active in the church. We need to focus on that and remember that. But do we see it? Can you see it? I can see it. And I praise God for that. And I pray that he continues to bless and be active in each one of you and in us as a fellowship of believers. The answer is, look to the cross. Amen. I'd ask the congregation to please rise. As we confess what we believe, the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord,
who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary,
suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended to heaven and sits at the right hand of God, the Father. From thence he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Christian Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Let us pray for the whole Church of God in Christ Jesus and for all people according to their needs. Lord of hosts, you have brought us to dwell in your house and called us to worship you in spirit and truth. Receive our praise and hear our prayers, that we would leave this place satisfied with your living water. Lord, in your mercy, Lord of hosts, you led your ancient people by the hand of Moses and Aaron. Lead us through the wilderness of this world by the hand of faithful pastors, that we would be refreshed by the living water flowing from the stricken side of Christ. Lord, in your mercy. Lord of hosts, you have made us righteous through Jesus Christ and made peace with us by his cross. Lead us to embrace our suffering in faith as they shape us in his image and prepare us to behold your glory in heaven. Lord, in your mercy. Lord of hosts, you appointed your Son to suffer on our behalf, that we would rejoice in the hope of glory. Make all Christian fathers to stand in your grace, that they would live faithfully for the sake of their families and urge them always towards eternal life. Lord, in your mercy. Lord of hosts, bless the nations of the world, that both citizens and authorities would seek justice, peace, and the common good of all. Lord, in your mercy. Lord of hosts, help the sick and the suffering, especially those who desire our prayers. Today we especially lift up Roy, Jim, Jeannie, Stetson, Dave, Tom, Greg, Katie, Miranda, Hazley, Cindy, Brindy, Elena, Alea, and Ray, Sandy, Vicky, and Klaus, and all those we hold dear and lift up to you in our hearts. Surround them with your love in Christ, and according to your gracious will, heal them, Lord, in your mercy. Lord of hosts, grant us safe haven at this altar, that we who bear the weight of this world and sorrows would always long for your courts and the blessings you have prepared for those who sing your praises. Lord, in your mercy. Lord God, Heavenly Father, to you all hearts are open and all sins are known. Strengthen our hearts by your grace, that we who daily sin much would make confession boldly and then joyfully receive your precious word of absolution. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. You may be seated as we continue with the Lord's offering. Please rise. Salutary that we should at all times and in all places give thanks to you, O Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Everlasting God, for the countless blessings you so freely bestowed on us and all creation. Above all, we give thanks for your boundless love shown to us when you sent your only begotten Son, Jesus Christ, into our flesh and laid on him our sin, giving him into death that we may not die eternally. Because he is now risen from the dead and lives and reigns through all eternity, all who believe in him will overcome sin and death and will rise again to new life. Therefore, with angels and archangels and all the company of heaven, we laud and magnify your glorious name, evermore praising you and saying, that whoever believes in him should not perish but have eternal life. At your command, Abraham prepared and ought to offer his son Isaac as a sacrifice on the mount. Yet, in your mercy, you provided a ram as a substitute. We give you thanks that on Calvary you spared not your only Son, but sent him to offer his life as a ransom for many. As we eat and drink his body and blood, grant us, like Abraham, our father, to trust in your promises, now fulfilled in Christ, the Lamb of God who takes away the sin of the world. Hear us as we pray in his name, and as he has taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, on the night when he's betrayed, he took the bread, and after giving thanks, he broke it, and he gave it to his disciples and said, "Take and eat. This is my body given to you in remembrance of me." After the same manner also, he took the cup, and after he had supped, he gave it to his disciples and said, "Drink from it, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, given to you for the forgiveness of all of your sins. Do this as often as you eat and drink it in remembrance of me." The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Thank you.
Gracious God, our Heavenly Father, you have given us a foretaste of the feast to come in the Holy Supper of your Son's body and blood. Keep us firm in the true faith throughout our days of pilgrimage, that on the day of his coming, we may together with all your saints celebrate the marriage feast of the Lamb and his kingdom, which has no end. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Peace of the Lord, and go and serve the Lord. Thank you for coming.